This video will provide indisputable evidence that there is a mathematical Bible code in the Bible and how it relates to the current end time we are living in today, and how it prophesies what will happen in the future.
Bible codes are there so when the future happens, it confirms Scripture as the divinely inspired Word of God.
I will be providing evidence of the ruler of the universe, aka God's influence, on the writing of the Bible, and specifically the Torah, the first five books of the Old Testament. This webpage by Jah, as an outline, show how the Bible has and can be used to predict the future. The Bible is two-thirds prophecy, of which 99.9% has come true already. Why would anyone not believe that the final 0.1% will not come true? Many people today are watching world events and prophecy unfolding. They are taught that if we only believe in Jesus, we are saved. There's more to do, and it's in the Torah. We should be following God's law and not following man's law that are actually the Vatican's law of Satan that is ushering in the new world order of evil.
Every major event in world history, every major figure in world history appears to be encoded in the Bible.
The Bible codes are a dramatic demonstration that what we have here really is the Word of God and not simply a historical tradition. These 66 books penned by 40 different guys over thousands of years are collectively a supernaturally given and skillfully engineered message system.
There is evidence that embedded within the Hebrew letters of what the Jews refer to as the Torah, that is Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, or the first five books of the Bible, there is a code that tells of events far into the future. A code that, according to some, could only have been put there by the original author, God himself.
Some researchers have even suggested that Yeshua, the Hebrew name for Jesus Christ, has been found to be part of these codes throughout the Old Testament.
Originally, it was thought that only the Torah contained Bible codes. We now know that the entire Tanakh, commonly known as the Old Testament, has encoded information within the Hebrew text. Also, software is presently being developed to determine if there is a Bible code present in the Textus Receptus, the Greek New Testament used for the King James Bible translation.
All the good from the Savior of the world is communicated through this book. All things desirable to men are contained in the Bible.
If we would destroy the Christian religion, we must first of all destroy man's belief in the Bible.
The Bible is the greatest benefit which the human race has ever experienced.
It is impossible to mentally or socially enslave a Bible-reading people.
A mathematical Bible code, secular proof that there is indeed an infinitely higher intelligence, God, in the universe. For 3,000 years, a secret code in the Bible has remained hidden. Now it has been unlocked by computer, and it may reveal our future. The code was broken by a distinguished mathematician and later corroborated by world-famous academics. It foretells events that happened thousands of years after it was incorporated into the Old Testament.
In 1994, Michael Drosnin, a writer and former journalist with the Wall Street Journal and the Washington Post, flew to Israel to meet with a close friend of then Prime Minister Yitzhak Rabin. He carried with him a letter with frightening implications.
Using the Bible code myself, about 2 years into my investigation, I found encoded the name of the Prime Minister of Israel, Yitzhak Rabin. The only time his name was encoded in the Bible, and crossing his name, as plain as day, were the words, "Assassin will assassinate." I was shocked.
Are you seriously suggesting the Torah actually says that Rabin will be assassinated?
All I can tell you is what's in there. Will you give him the letter?
In his letter, Michael Drosnin told the Prime Minister, I have uncovered information that suggests your life is in danger. He went on to explain that it was an Israeli mathematician that had discovered a hidden code in the Bible that appears to reveal the details of events that took place thousands of years after the Bible was written. The letter also pointed out that the information had been confirmed by famous mathematicians, and the results have been replicated by a senior codebreaker at the Pentagon using his own computer program.
This should not be ignored.
Guri read the letter, but his response was not very encouraging.
All right, I'll take it to him. But I know the Prime Minister, and I don't believe he'll pay any attention to these Bible codes.
Guri's assessment proved all too accurate. The Prime Minister made no attempt to contact Drosnin and apparently ignored the warning completely.
And of course, a year later, he was killed. Exactly as the Bible code said he would be, indeed in the very year that the Bible code said he would be killed. All found a year in advance. I failed. Because I had tried to warn the Prime Minister. I had managed to put the warning in his hands. He'd ignored the warning, and now he was dead.
It has been confirmed by eminent mathematicians at the prestigious American universities of Harvard and Yale, including David Kasnan at Harvard and Shapiro at Yale, and been replicated by a senior codebreaker, Harold Gans, at the United States Department of Defense, who tested it with his own computer program.
Harold Gans, at the time a senior cryptologist at the National Security Agency in Maryland, heard of the test and the results.
I reproduced the experiment, and lo and behold, I got precisely the results that they had reported. I then went ahead and did a new experiment. Instead of pairing each of the rabbis' names and appellations with their dates of birth and death, I paired them with the places of birth and death. Cities, towns, villages, wherever it was they died or were born. And the results I got were even more significant than the original experiment done by Whitstam and Ripps. At that point, I knew beyond any shadow of a doubt that the code was real. I felt a chill go up my spine.
Encouraged by the results, the study was sent to the prestigious American mathematics journal Statistical Science for peer review and possible publication. Indeed, nothing is published in Statistical Science until it's been thoroughly reviewed by at least one independent referee, and on occasion two. In this instance, the documentation was submitted to three separate referees. Following its publication, a statement was issued by five mathematical scholars, two from Harvard University, one from Yale University, and two from Hebrew University, supporting the finding.
People have claimed that they found similar codes in Moby Dick and War and Peace, that they could find similar codes in any text of one's choice. That is absolute nonsense. They have indeed produced counterfeit codes in War and Peace and in Moby Dick, and they can produce them in virtually any text. They are not the same as the real thing. They are not done a priori, they are done by cheating. Their claim is that since we can cheat on the data and bias the experiment to do whatever we want, therefore, Whitstam and Ripps could have done the same, and therefore we shall assume that they have done the same. They do not deal at all with the fact that my city's experiment proves that that is not the case. And by the way, to accept their challenge, I would say, I would like to see them try to produce an experiment like my city's experiment to confirm their rabbi's experiment that succeeded so well in War and Peace. They haven't done so. They haven't even addressed the city's experiment because it proves that, in fact, there was no such manipulation. What they have done is very similar to what Whitstam and Ripps have done. To the layperson, to the expert, they have nothing in common.
Behind every picture is a statistical analysis that's performed by the computer program Ripps and his colleagues have created. It's not just a picture. It's not words that appear together by chance in the Bible. It is accurate, related details of major world events that appear together way beyond mathematical chance.
In addition to other assassinations, hundreds of other world-shaking events are also encoded in the Bible. Everything from World War II to Watergate, from Winston Churchill to Bill Clinton, from the Holocaust to Hiroshima, from the moon landing to the collision of a comet, Shoemaker-Levey, with Jupiter.
World War I had proven that being able to break enemy codes was absolutely vital to winning a war. By the time the Second World War broke out, cryptanalysis, the art of making and breaking codes, was well on its way to becoming a science. When America entered the war, the fledgling U.S. Signal Corps, later the National Security Agency, was able to keep one step ahead of the constantly mutating code, giving Allied generals and admirals advanced knowledge of German strategy. But in order to keep up with the ever-changing code, they had been forced to devise a means of making the large numbers of calculations required. What they came up with was a huge mechanical calculator they called a computation machine. These computation machines made cryptanalysis a viable science. As it turned out, they also gave the United States a huge advantage in harnessing the energy that would change the world.
During World War II, we, of course, were on a crash program to develop the atomic bomb.
Can the code be used to let us see into the future?
The Bible codes are there, so when the future happens, it confirms Scripture as the divinely inspired Word of God.
The Bible code reveals accurate details about people and events that took place, who lived long after the Bible was written. We can go to events as recent as the bombing in Oklahoma, where we have the name of the building that was blown up, the Murrah Building, encoded, Oklahoma encoded, even the name of the man who was arrested and convicted for the crime, Timothy McVeigh, all encoded in a document that's 3,000 years old. Watergate is encoded. The one time that word appears, there's a question: who is he? President, but he was kicked out. Economic crisis is encoded one time in the Bible, and with it is the year of the great stock market crash, the year the Great Depression began, 1929. The collision of the comet with Jupiter in July 1994, found 2 months before the collision took place, was encoded twice in the Old Testament, with the exact name of the comet, Shoemaker-Levy, which had only been discovered a year earlier. In both cases, the name of the comet actually crossed the name of the planet, Jupiter, and in one of the encodings, we had the exact day of impact.
Shoemaker-Levy is not a man-made disaster, so it can't be said that man wrote the Bible and is following a script.
World War II and the Holocaust are very clearly encoded in extraordinary detail. We have Hitler encoded with Nazi, an enemy, an evil man, and slaughter.
The Bible rightly states that God gave the Torah to Moses, which is born out of the discovery of the Bible, the mathematical code, Jah. JahTruth.net is a website that will provide the ultimate, that is, the final source of the truth on earth in these end times. It is obvious that God not only authored the Torah, the laws that the planet must follow, but he sent his son twice to show us how to go home to heaven. Jesus came 2,000 years ago, and today, as was prophesied, has come in person to give us the little book that was prophesied in the book of Revelations. And the voice which I heard from heaven spoke unto me again and said, go and take the little book.